So things I'm in love with this month. So these are just like from the drugstore. The Clean and Clear Finishes line. This is the Finishes Mattifying Cleanser. That's in the pink tube. And then the Finishes Mattifying Moisturizer in the white tube. So I wash my face with the cleanser in the mornings. I use something different at nighttime only because I use my Clarisonic at night. So I use my Cetaphil actually. So I use this in the morning. It does say in the back to leave on for 1 minute for the best results. So I do leave it on for 1 minute, then wash it off, and it is amazing, especially when you use it in conjunction with the moisturizer. Moisturizer has SPF 15, so that's really good. Next thing is, this entire month, I've really kind of been loving blue nail polishes. I think I only had 2 blue nail polishes in my entire nail polish collection until recently. I don't know why, but blues just kind of look attractive to me lately, especially for the fall and winter. I picked this up when I went to Sally's Beauty Supply the other day. Not the other day, like 2 weeks ago. This is in the color First Mate, and it's just a really pretty blue. Next thing is this Laura Mercier Eye Basics in Wheat. And I got this from my Sephora Friends and Family haul. A couple videos back, I used my 500 point perk to get the Laura Mercier kit. And this came in it, and I've been using it ever since, every single day. Totally love it. So, next is this BB cream. This is a Skin 79 BB cream. This is the Triple Functions one. This is in the older packaging because I've had this BB cream for a couple months now, but it is my favorite. It does leave a gray undertone to my skin. I will only use this BB cream mixed with a foundation. So I do one full pump of this BB cream, and one full pump is like a lot. And if you hear all that noise, my crazy dog. One full pump is like a lot of product that comes out. So I do that, and then I use a half a pump of my MAC Studio Fix Fluid Foundation and mix it together, and the foundation kind of just evens out the grayness, and it doesn't have like that gray cast on me. I just use setting powder and I'm all set. So totally been loving that. Just on days where I don't really feel like heavy coverage, I don't really want to slap on a ton of foundation, I'll mix this. And that's been a lot of days this month, so totally love this BB cream. The next product is a self tanning lotion. I'm not a big self tanning lotion person, but I have kind of gradually stopped I have gradually stopped going to the tanning salon. So I used to go to the tanning salon to get a Mystic tan. Started not liking did I just turn blue Started not liking the whole Mystic tan look. Just the way it faded was really god awful. Like, I just started streaking like crazy. It was no good. So I decided to try this out. This is a product by Sun Labs, and this is in the color Dark. I know it comes in ultra dark, but this is just dark. I do have it on right now. You probably can't really tell because the lighting is kind of washing me out. But, yeah, it's the one that's like yummy chocolate brown. And it has a very pleasant smell for being a self-tanner, and it works really, really well. Totally in love with this stuff. So this is my only form of tanning that I've got all month. Totally love it. I only have 2 more things, or actually no, 3. Next product is a drugstore product, and this is the Maybelline New Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser. Okay, so this is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser, a treatment concealer with goji berry and Haloxyl. I don't know what the hell that is. I'm in the color 50. This is the neutralizer, so it's not an actual concealer. It's just supposed to neutralize the darkness under your eyes. A lot of people put this on and then apply concealer. I personally just like this product by itself. I apply this underneath my foundation and I apply a little bit more after foundation and then I set it. Totally love it. It is like the best drugstore foundation, best drugstore concealer I have tried. Okay, now there is only two more things. I am totally in love with these face masks. This is the My Beauty Diary Black Pearl masks. You can usually get this like at Asian stores. I actually got this, my mom recently went out of the country, she visited Taiwan for a couple weeks, and she sent me a care package. I did do a haul video on all the stuff that she got me while she was in Taiwan. I don't know why I didn't upload it, I don't think that I really liked the way I looked in that video, and I'm pretty sure I hated the lighting also. I don't know if I'm gonna upload that, so if you guys are really interested in seeing it, I will. But this was one of the products, and it came with 10 sheets, and I think you're supposed to use this like twice a week. I've only been doing it once a week, sometimes two. So I've already used up four of them, but they come in like packs like this, and they're just like the cloth white face masks that make you look totally scary when you put it on. But I totally love these ones. I've always wanted to try my Beauty Diary face masks, and I've always had my eye on the Black Pearl ones, so I'm super excited that she got me these. Totally in love with them, totally gonna buy more. That's one of the only reasons that I am showing this also in the favorites video, is because I know if anyone's interested in this, you can purchase these off of Amazon.com. Pretty sure you can get them off eBay. I would trust Amazon more than I would trust eBay though. And I mean, they sell this like, if you just have like any Asian type markets or any Asian beauty stores, most of them will carry My Beauty Diary products. I don't know if they'll have the Black Pearl one, but My Beauty Diary does make lots and lots and lots of different types of masks like these. I just like the Black Pearl one. So, I mean, it's the only one I've tried so far, but I love it. Last product is a perfume. I usually don't feature like scents too much in any of my past monthly favorites, only because I already have scents that I like and I wear them all the time. So like my Juicy Couture Viva La Juicy perfume, I pretty much wear that on a daily basis. Like, I love that perfume, so I don't really switch up my scents too much when I have a favorite. So that one and Miss Dior Cherie are my two faves, and I just always wear those. So that's why I don't really feature too many scents on my monthly favorites, because it's usually one or the other of the two. But I just re-fell in love with this perfume. I've had this for so long. I think this is one of like my first perfumes that I ever got, and it's totally cheesy. Some people think getting scents by celebrities is cheesy. I don't. This is the Britney Spears Curious. I think it's Curious. I have three Britney scents because I love Britney. And this was the first one that I ever got. I don't know why I never like loved this. I think like I first got this, I don't know, I hated the smell. I thought it was kind of like too old lady-ish. I must have been really immature when I got this. I don't know. It is so amazing. Like, it's one of those scents that when you wear it, it's so long lasting throughout the day, but when you wear it, it kind of like gets better as time goes by throughout the day, or like by midday, it's like the most amazing scent ever. Like today I was wearing it, and I'm usually used to, again, like my Miss Dior Cherie or my Viva La Juicy, and I kept like, if I'd like walk away from my desk and I'd walk back, I'd still kind of get like a whiff of it, and I'd forget that I was wearing it, and I'd be like, what is that amazing perfume? Who was wearing that? It was me. So this is so amazing. It's got, it's like a really florally perfume. It's like a perfect everyday perfume. It's a light, clean, florally scent. And it has some kind of fruit. Like, I don't know. Apple? No. Kind of smells like Asian pears. It smells really good. I'm really terrible with, like, explaining the notes in scents. It smells freaking amazing. So, Britney Spears, Curious. If you don't have it, go buy it. Looks like this. Super pretty bottle. But yeah, so those were my favorites for the month of November. Thank you all so much for watching and subscribing if you have, and I will see you guys in my next video.